will eliminate you out of their mouth. There is a man who is waiting for you to pass through their table. They are waiting for your document to come to their table for them to punish you. They will be transferred before your document will get to their table. Before your document will get to their table, they will have an appointment to travel. It is not because they want them to travel. The Lord is doing a reshuffle for your sake. The Lord is going to reshuffle some people for some places. There is a doctor that constantly is being used as a weapon against you. His announcement is not a good news. The same doctor has been on your case for so long and he doesn't see any positive thing coming out of your life. All of a sudden, you go to the place the doctor has traveled. You are sad about the news, but the Lord has removed the man from the place and brought somebody else who is going to demand for a new medical report. I declare that this week, good news shall come your way. You shall not encounter any form of bad news. I pray in the name of Jesus that you shall be different from other people. You shall be a different person from other people. You will deliver and your child will be stronger. I declare in the name of Jesus that this week no bad news will come you. No harm shall befall your dwelling. You will not find yourself being selected for evil thought. Nobody will plan evil and evil will survive in your life. Their evil nature will stop at their doorstep. Evilness will pay back at their doorstep. He said, whoever pays God back for evil, evil shall not depart from their doorstep. It shall become their doormat. It shall be what they clean their feet on. I pray this week that you shall be different from the Egyptian women. May the Lord separate us from the Egyptians. May the Lord separate us from the Egyptians. In the midst of our life, may the Lord separate us from the Egyptians. Say in the name of Jesus. Say in the name of Jesus. As I lift up my voice and I pray, oh Lord, separate me as a Hebrew from the Egyptian people. May you select me out of the evil ones. May you eliminate me from the evil orchestration. May I be vigorous and stronger for my destiny oriented to come to pass. I declare in the name of Jesus that the Bible says in the book of Psalm 34, and I love to read for you from verse 1. It says, I will exalt the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. I will glory in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. 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 Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers them from it all. You don't get what I'm talking about, because the Bible says that you can be afflicted, you can be hard pressed, but the Lord will deliver you from it all. I came to tell you that whatever condition they have for you this week, as you walk through this week, every affliction, you shall be delivered. You shall be delivered. Bible says in the book of Psalm 34, reading from verse number 19, it says, the righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers him from them all. There can be many are the afflictions of the righteous. Many are the troubles of the Hebrew woman. Many are the problems of the one who have decided to rely on God. But God will come through. God will come through. God will come through. You can be hard pressed. You can be crushed down. But as you walk through this week, may the Lord come to deliver. May he deliver you. May the Lord bring you deliverance. May deliverance come to you this week. As you walk through this week, may nothing become a burden for you, but rather may it become a blessing in the name of Jesus. I declare that whoever is sitting on your joy, may there be a level of foolishness in their life. May the counsel of Ahithophel become foolish. 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 There is a level of foolishness that must be attached to people who are attacking you. You want to declare that everybody who is respected in society, everybody who is above you, may their counsel become foolish. May the counsel of Ahithophel become foolish. Hallelujah. May the counsel of Ahithophel become foolish. The counsel of Ahithophel was full of wisdom. May the counsel of Ahithophel become useless. May the counsel of Ahithophel become useless. May God not hear the counsel of Ahithophel anymore. May Ahithophel's counsel, may the counsel of Ahithophel become useless. May the counsel of Ahithophel become hopeless. May the counsel of Ahithophel become useless in the ears of God. May God not hear the counsel of Ahithophel again. Because you know the problem is that Ahithophel was a good counselor. And David's counselor was Ahithophel. David consulted from Ahithophel. But he prayed and said, "Oh God, let the counsel of Ahithophel become useless." You don't understand why somebody will come back to the same person that they have had joy in before. Somebody that they have lived with before. Somebody that they have become powerful before. All of a sudden, they go back and say, "I don't want to hear from them again." Because the Bible says that in the book of 2 Samuel, chapter number 15 and from verse 31, their people can block you and they don't want you to survive. No, you didn't hear what I said. There are people who you have introduced as good people. Now watch the book of, now watch it here. Now watch it here. 2 Samuel chapter 15. And let me read from verse number 31. And one told David saying, "Ahithophel is among the conspirators with Absalom." And David said, "O Lord, I pray thee, turn the counsel of Ahithophel into foolishness." I don't know if you have your own Bible. There are people that you have shared your past with. There are people that you have told them what you are going through. There are people that you have discussed with them about your scholarship. There are people that you have told them about your marriage. There are people that you have spoken to about a business plan. Joyce, there are people that you have narrated to them the reason why you are still not having a child. There are people that you think they are the best resource people in your life. And they look good in the face. They look better and well presented. But unfortunately for you, they are the evil people in a woolly, in a sheep's wool. You don't know them. You can't identify them by face. But all you can do is to pray. My Bible says, pray without ceasing. What if is the condition? Maybe you don't know. You don't know. There's a child that he can give to you. You see, there are people that they were living peaceful until they got married. And after marriage, the marriage was so exciting that everybody was happy at their marriage ceremony. All of a sudden, they got pregnant. The pregnancy, they didn't struggle to get the pregnancy. But after delivery, their child had become their source of bad news. Won't ya see? Dia me kanu nyantia see. Nipa daseni enwale ya no na nani ji abotobem abeye bem. Ni bibia etoso kama. Bibia obeye bia no bibia obeye bia no esi ni ye. Onim dia ko ba ya awale ba wieye mbo no nipa daseni nani nje. When you were not even employed, you were more joyful than you had this job. Ever since you had this employment, things are not going down well with you because somebody took your information and is using your own information against you. You want to declare in the name of Jesus, anywhere my information is that they are using against me, let their usage become foolishness. My God, let their usage become foolishness. In the book of 2 Samuel chapter 15 verse 31, every king needed a counselor. Every king needed an advisor. Everybody needs somebody. You can't make it alone. But if wrong people come your way, they will break you. They will change your destiny. They will cause you not to survive. You want to declare in the name of Jesus, every bad news announcer in my team, I eliminate them and cause their counsel to become foolishness. My God, is when the people, you don't understand what I'm talking about. When the king came to tell the midwives, that midwives kill every boy that is born, they told the king that, king, we can't do this. The Bible says, because they feared God, because the fear of God was in them, they told the king the truth. We cannot kill these children. We cannot kill the sons that have been born. That was the time that Moses was born. If you are killing every child, survival becomes difficult. Everybody's business must collapse in the country. Everybody, nobody comes to establish a business and it will go, because the person who is the business advisor is becoming more powerful because he has too much announcement. You want to pray, your prayer partner can become an Ahithophel. Your prayer partner can become an Ahithophel. Your financier can become an Ahithophel. Bible says that a man's enemy is but from his own family. When people are far away from you, they cannot attack you. It is when they are close to you. So when people are close to you, they are those that can kill you. Ajagaja was saying something last week, and I watched. He says he doesn't drink plastic water because his junior pastors can be given poison to inject and kill him. So he drinks water in the bottle. I've been thinking about it. Because if you want to kill a man, get closer to him through his own people. When Jesus Christ was supposed to be sold out so that our salvation will come, they didn't come and attack him gidigidi. They used Judas around him. And Judas gave them a clue. The kiss of Judas meant not evil to Jesus. The things they do close to you have no sign of evilness. But all of a sudden, they are planting your downfall. And when the crocodile is dead in the river, and the fish come to tell you that the crocodile is dead, you cannot say it's a lie because you are not in the water with the crocodile. The Ahithophel was lifted up by David. David made everybody believe in the counsel of Ahithophel. David made everybody believe that when you hear the voice of Ahithophel, it is my voice. Everybody made, you have established the man so much that all your business partners believe in him. When he goes to tell them you are a thief, nobody will deny it. This week you want to pray and declare in the name of Jesus, every close person who has my information that will use it against me, let their thought become foolishness. I command the Lord, let their counsel become foolishness. Whatever they have using against me, I dry their source. I declare that nobody will listen to them. Their pages will become blunt. They will become